that has come, and the land is done, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand by me. Darling, stand by me. Won't you stand by me when you're in need? Won't you stand by me? And when the sky look upon shall crumble and fall, and the mountains will fall to the sea, no, I won't be afraid. No, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. Darling, stand by me. Won't you stand by me when you're in need? Won't you stand by me? Stand by me. Won't you stand by me? And if you need, won't you stand by me? Darling, stand by me. Won't you stand by me? And if you're in need, won't you stand by me?
Hey, wasn't that something? Wasn't that something? Gorgeous George singing Stand By Me. Well, I think you'll be sitting down soon, so you don't have to stand so much. My name is Kay Lazar. This is...
Vinnie Mac.
What's your name again? Vinnie Mac.
Yes.
And welcome to a very special episode of The Gorgeous George Show. We have a new set. We have a couch and a desk.
Yeah.
There's no drawers in this desk. I was looking for a stapler to staple these things together. And this wonderful couch
here.
It looks like the back of a Greyhound bus. But it'll work.
All loan from Jay Leno.
Yes, I'm loan from Jay. Oh, listen, on this show we care about, you know, the other shows worry about the gay movement, the women's movement, the labor movement. Only thing George cares about is the bowel movement. So here he is. Wow, you're all dressed up and raring to go. All right, George, get thee behind me.
That's right.
Enjoy.
Get thee behind you.
I will sit
on the couch. Yes.
Okay. We're going to do it. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the Gorgeous George Show, and I think we have...
I'm the Headless Horseman right now.
You're the Headless Horseman. I say that. We have no camera guy tonight, so we're going to be a little bit out of touch with no camera guy.
We'll do all right.
But that's fine. Vince, do you see the lever in the back?
I think it looks fine. Okay. Wait, well, yeah, okay.
Push the lever if you would, my friend, please.
Yes.
Okay, no. let me go back. Charm the people out there, and we'll be right back. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Charm them back.
George was a little late getting here. George was a little late getting here. He was, look how humiliating I feel talking in this thing. George was a little late getting here. He was in line to see the Pope, to mourn the Pope in Rome, and he tried to cut in the front of the line like, you know, like he was in high school or something, and it just didn't work out for him. So anyway, let me tell you, let me tell you what's going on. We'll be back later in the summer. This is a special one-time showing of the show. We are trying to check out this new set, and boy, what a what a beautiful set we have here. We look like little stick figures here, but here we go. Now, George, I think it's back to square tacks here. Okay. There we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Gorgeous George in effect. What is causing all this? I am, baby, the only person on Continental Cable and Media One or Comcast or whatever you want to call it. I am what's causing all this. Just do a close-up. Woo, baby, woo!
That's not so close.
And well, it's all right. It's going to work for now. We got a lot to talk about in a short time of doing in. Tonight, we're doing a special show. The gracious management has granted us to be doing a special show for you all. And we're going to do it with you, as we always do. Except no substitute. There's one Mona Lisa, and there's one Leaning Tower of Pisa, baby. And there's only one Gorgeous George. Yeah. And, you know, others try. Others, you know, often imitated, but never duplicated. And, you know, it was a breath of fresh air for my fans to see me back on this channel. We've been busy. We're doing some production. We're doing some, we're doing a lot of takes. And we were on other channels in Northern Virginia and Reston and Albuquerque, New Mexico. And we're just working the whole gamut. And that's what it boils down to, baby. We are what's causing all this. And Kevin, I'm glad to see that you're here tonight.
Yes. You know, we have a lot in common. We both have the same nickname, Uncle Milty.
Okay.
They call him Uncle Milty because he's Mr. Television.
Right.
My girlfriends call me Uncle Milty for a whole different reason. I don't know why. I kind of lost on it, but sooner or later they'll tell me why.
Right. we might not have any phone lines tonight, neither. So.
Is that a big mistake?
It could be a big mistake, but it's never a problem. But we can always work upon that.
It's gonna ring.
It's gonna jingle
it's gonna
in a second. I'm sure the lines.
It's gonna jingle all the way.
But that's all. It's all fine and good. We are a little short tonight. Camera guy's not here, but we don't care because I have to give him the exit door because it's either my way, baby, woo, or the highway. Woo! Now, we're going to get into a lot here. As you know, a lot has happened. We're going to go into the serious topics first. Change of plans, and we'll get right into it. Terri Schiavo, the case with Terri Schiavo, the lady who they had the tube for the past 15 years or 20-some years in the tube, and very controversial thing to know about. We know that, you know, you want someone to live. The people in Congress, I'll tell you this, had no business getting involved in the situation. They had no business really getting involved in that situation. But you look at it from the standpoint that the people who obviously wanted to keep her alive were her family.
Yes.
Her mother and father.
Yes.
Her husband obviously wanted to take a life insurance policy on her and watch her go. Now,
he couldn't wait. He was counting the money.
I understand the situation. Go ahead and do both. There you go.
Oh, there I
am. I understand the situation of the deal where, you know, how it is in some aspects where, you know, you don't want someone to suffer. Okay.
Yes.
And she's been suffering for the longest time. I understand that. Congress obviously intervened in the sakes of for the parents' sake.
Mm-hmm.
You never should get involved. Congress, I mean, church and state should never mix, and neither should the situation with Congress putting their head involved in it. They should have never got into it. But the situation is maybe it was time for her to go. Maybe she had to go. Maybe, you know, if the fact that she was a vegetable. But this man obviously was not by her side all the time. This man was not with her all the time. This man was doing his own little thing, and he was shacked up with someone else.
Yeah, two kids.
And it wasn't really by her bedside until it all was talked about trying to get the tube pulled out. Vince, I know you can't be on camera. I know you want to say something, so I'll have you talk in the back. Come on in here, and No, just the voice from the back. Vince.
The voice of God.
Voice of God. What's your take on this?
Well, step in front of it. Step in front.
What's your take? Yes.
Yes.
What's your take? You can pop your head.
We have an audience member who has something to say.
Yes.
Okay, sit down here.
Whoa. I don't want to spill the drink.
You don't want to spill the drink.
Whoa.
We can't see.
Okay, you see you? Okay.
Hey.
Okay, there you go.
That's good.
Nice little family here.
Is this really Jay Leno?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's the Johnny Carson show. Now, ironically, we had this little discussion about the couch. Mm-hmm. It was my idea for management in here to have a couch in here. It was my idea for management to go ahead and put a couch in here, and that's what it was. So, you know, thanks. I don't know. What's your take upon this whole case with Mrs. Terry Schiavo?
My take is, like, I wish she would have just lived, and then she would just simply gotten out of that vegetable state and then just beat up her husband. Because, well, you know, he was shacking up. Like, just like what you were saying. He was shacking up, had a mistress on the side, but, yeah, 15, 20 years.
Well, he's been living with her for, like, 11 years. He has two kids. He has, you know, it wasn't all that important that she live or die, because he had already moved on. The problem was that it's all, as they say in Watergate, follow the money, you'll find the real villain. There was insurance policy on the woman. She was worth nothing to him alive. In fact, she was a drain on the insurance and everything, and on Uncle Sam, whoever. And of course, you know, the people who truly love somebody really want her to remain alive. You know, if we allowed this to happen, of course, on an individual basis, it, you know, maybe her time has come, like you said. But if we made a blanket ruling that this could happen, then it's going, people with Alzheimer's, people who've been in a vegetative state for 20 years or so, then we will okay, it's time for you to go now. You've outlasted your welcome. That's why living wills are important. That's why, you know.
Well, all this isn't important, too, but, to play devil's advocate, I've got mixed feelings. I'm on the fence both ways. I don't think that, she is a vegetable. I mean, she is technically a vegetable, and she was in that state for a long time. But the problem that I have, and I guess I fall right on the line on this, the problem that I have is the fact that nothing was done to try to help the situation, yet she was, they were paying, she was sitting in the hospital, wasting away in the hospital, but the husband never really did anything to help the situation. The husband was not, didn't really care. He was obviously with someone else, shacked up with someone else. Actually, I think he's married to someone else.
Yes.
Well, he's not really married, because he was married to her. Well, he was living with the woman. Right. A common law.
Of course, common law is legit.
Which means living with somebody.
Common law is legit in most cases. But knowing that and knowing the situation for where it is, you know, I mean, The whole brass tacks is that there's some monkey business going on. And I have a problem with Congress. I have a problem with Congress and it being in the courts. You know, living wills are great and all that, but I think that, you know, under the circumstances, the parents had more of a dog in the situation, even though she was a vegetable. I got mixed feelings about it. I got mixed feelings about such a thing.
How many times are you going to say vegetable in that? Anyway, because you're making me hungry. Well, anyway,
she was the soup de la jour, la vegetable.
Le vegetal. Oh. Anyway, let me tell. No, the it's never a pleasant thing, and the best thing to do don't get hospitalization, because if you don't have your hospitalization, they'll just pull the plug on you anyway because you can't pay your bills. So that's the best way to do it. That's your living will right there. Now at the same time, what we learned about all of this is that the president, the governor of Florida, all these people weighed in, Congress, everybody had their say. A local judge, the Supreme Court could overrule a local judge, but now we know the president of the United States cannot overrule a local judge's decision. So is that...
Well, I don't know. It's just like I said, it's not something like this. You know, it's like, it's also like abortion, too. I mean, abortion is... I'm on the fence with that too. I know if I impregnate a woman, whether it be by accident, I mean, I'm not going to run and hide. I mean, if I impregnate a woman, I'm, you know, according to the circumstances, of course, if the kid is Down syndrome or is retarded, then under upon that, or upon the kid being raped, or not kid, but upon the woman being raped, easy.
You believe in
eugenics? Upon the woman being raped, then obviously, then and only then you know, an abortion falls. But then if it's a, you know, if it's wedlock or if it's not a plan out of love, I mean, you know, stand up to the plate, guys. You stand up to the plate, guys, and take responsibility for the seed that was planted.
Well, I believe either you should have abortion or you shouldn't have it. In case people talk about rape and incest and, mm-hmm. and like you said, retarded kids and stuff. But the truth is, it's not that case. People have abortions of healthy kids, and thus, or healthy would be a healthy people,
right.
and thus, if it's legal for that, it's legal for everything. If it's not legal, it's not legal. It truly is a black and white issue.
I'm just saying that I'm on the fence because you're like retarded or someone's, you know, someone who's been out of a rape or whatnot. Yeah, definitely. And then you need to abort. But if it's a normal child, you know, or if it's a child that I might have planted, ladies, because we'll get into that in a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Then and only then it should be alive.
Yes. Yeah.
Now I'm channeling here for a second.
He
I'm
like
channeling. Go ahead and do what you're doing. I'll talk for a second. I'm channeling.
Yes. Okay.
I'm channeling.
All right.
Oh,
we
I'm
have.
Channeling.
I think we have somebody coming to join us here. Oh, look at him.
Oh, my gums. My gums are hurting.
What are you up to?
Who the hell are you?
Oh, I'm nobody.
You're nobody.
Kayla Czar is my name, and girls are my game.
Your masturbation, your game. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, you know who I am? My name is Henry. You haven't seen me in a few times. I've lost all my hair, and I have no hair at all, only in that certain spot where we can't show you. But tonight, there needs to be a vote.
Yeah.
And I was running for president back in November. I didn't have a chance in hell, but I still believed in sexual freedom. And if you wanted to do it to your neighbor or your ex or your lover, if you wanted to do it, you go ahead and do it like that. It's just easy like that. But tonight, I'm here. When I ran for president, you know, and I lost, but that's all right. I now want to become your pope. I want to become Pope Henry. I want to become Pope Henry Bofetius III.
You'd be good. All you need is that little hat on top of your head, and you'd be great. The white. You almost have sort of a popish gown.
Yeah,
holiness.
Well, you know, it's just one of those things.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think I've got the look for it. I've got the stern look for it. I've got the features. I've got the sculptured beautiful cheekbones and face. Yeah. You know, I think I'd make a good damn good pope.
Pope always has that Jimmy Durante look, I've noticed, and you have it perfect.
I can channel. I'm your father.
Yeah.
Holy oil ointment.
Good.
Yes,
you're
I
good.
Think so.
And the celibacy you'd have no problem handling. I gathered your age.
No. Let me tell you.
The only obstacle?
No, one thing you don't know about Henry.
Yeah.
You know, you first of all, do you know who you're talking to? Do you know who the hell you're talking to?
A blue wall? Oh, there's something in the way. I'm sorry.
I'm telling you something, man. Take some notes and listen to what Henry's got to say.
Yes.
I am very virile.
Yeah.
You didn't know that, did you?
We love a virile pope.
I'm virile.
And
I do. And when I shake hands, I shake hands like this.
Yeah.
Just like that. It's very distinction.
Yes.
You're very distinctful.
Yeah.
Also, I mean, I could be your grandfather.
You should be the patron saint of retards. I think if you became pope, they would probably.
Do you want an enema? Have you had an enema before?
No, no.
She's like you need one.
Could we all have
there.
One, huh?
For that top mouth there, you need an enema. I'll give you a pill.
Yeah.
You can swallow.
Yeah.
Now, anyway.
That's a pill that's hard to swallow, yeah.
Can you swallow that pill?
Yeah. You remind me sort of like the banjo-playing kid from Deliverance, now that he's gotten old. That was like 30 years ago, I guess. Are you the banjo-playing kid from Deliverance?
I'm just the old man that... You know, they wanted me to do that BK commercial instead of
Oh,
Hooters.
Yeah.
You know, and I said, BK, bacon, cheddar, ranch, burger at Burger King.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, Hootie had the voice. And I said, well, I don't, you know, hey, put him on there and put my face on there because I'm more distinguished looking.
Yeah. You know who should have done that commercial, Gorgeous George? I heard him sing a really good version of Stand By Me earlier.
I think that, you know, basically the Gorgeous George has got it going on. I know that. Gorgeous George has got it going on in all the right places, and we know that.
Yeah.
So I think that, you know, it's time to let you all people know that, yes, I am the cardinal. I am the cardinal to the man to choose.
Yeah.
I'm the one to choose, and I feel that if you choose me, you know, it'll be the great selection. Now, Pope John Paul and I were, I called Pope John Paul one time on the phone, and he was playing tiddlywinks. Like, God told him, now listen here, I'm Catholic.
Yeah.
Why don't you go out with me sometime? We'll go out to the, stripper bar. I'll go out to the stripper bar and see some beautiful ladies.
Rescue some ladies.
No, see some beautiful ladies. Put the fishing rod out if you know what I'm talking about. And go out there fishing.
Yeah.
Well, you know, he told me, no.
Confession.
I need to stay here, and I'm holy. I said, well, you're a holy man, but come on out sometime. You got to go out and bust a move sometime.
Yeah.
I told the Pope that. He needs to bust a move.
Yeah.
But he ain't no listen to me. But, you know, with Henry, you get the sacred times when I'm on the phone talking to God. Mm-hmm. I'll talk to God. I'll call him collect. He'll take my call.
The cat upstairs you
talk
to?
Yes.
All right.
He'll get my
call.
Sammy
Davis needs a call.
That's right. You know, it doesn't matter either way.
Yeah.
But anyway, I know one thing.
Well, I think you'd be very sympathetic. Because you
that
have everybody, you have my sympathy right now.
Do you?
Yeah, so I think you'd be a very sympathetic Pope.
Right. Is that a receding hairline I see on your hair? On your It doesn't really matter. I shaved it off.
That's my favorite color.
Do you like that color?
I like your hair color. Neat.
Do you like that?
Yes.
Well, I would rather have no hair than have a receding hairline.
I know. It's all comb over. I go to Rudolph Giuliani's barber.
Why don't you go ahead and glue some rice on there? Put some rice-a-roni on there.
Rice-a-roni,
Go ahead and do that. Ladies and gentlemen,
yes.
Pope Henry Bofetius III.
Yes.
I'll be a great pope. Get down on your hands and knees. I'll sprinkle holy water on all of you. Pope John Paul II was great. But Pope Henry Bofetius III will take over. Guaranteed. Now, I got a channel back in here. I got to get off screen because the gorgeous one is coming back.
Well, I don't know what.
Jesus Louise!
What happened, man?
It's channeling. I
you were like you like transformed into somebody.
I don't know what I transformed
into.
Yeah. Tonight, we're gonna get right into it.
I was gonna ask Henry a question, but it seems like
we'll email him.
Well, you got to email.
I'll answer him.
He's gone.
Secretary.
I'm gonna need you right now, if you would. We're gonna do the close-up camera, which I need to. Have you do that?
Well, I can hold it up.
And we're going to do this tonight. Tonight, it is a wonderful show. We're going to do one. This is going to be one of our highlighted shows, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Gorgeous George's top 10 women he wants to impregnate.
Yes.
And we're going to do it right now. The top 10 women that Gorgeous George wants to impregnate. Now, I need...
It's like a David Letterman show.
Okay. Vince, I need you to come in here with a camera and go close to me, to my face. And bring it close.
All the radiation.
Actually, move it. Ooh, move it to me. Come here. Ooh, yes.
It's an earthquake.
Okay, now raise it up. Raise it up. Okay, you got to close in zoom right there. Close. Come closer.
Not the right way.
Okay, now look. Can we? Okay. I want to look at some. Okay. You got this. Okay. Is that coming in clear?
No. I'll hold it right in front of the camera.
No, put a zoom in that if you would, Mr. Vince, please.
All right.
Now, this is the love baby right here. Okay, that's cool. That's cool right there. You can't really see the writing, but that's fine. This is the love baby. Now, we're going to start now. This is the Gorgeous George baby that was created. And we're not going to tell you who just yet created that baby, but we'll get into it in just a second. Okay. I'll move my head down.
Yeah, because we only see your mouth.
Okay, adjust that. Okay, and then when I come with the camera, then just push that. We got it going on. The Gorgeous George love baby was created by, and I'm going to play multiple guests.
Yeah.
Now, if you get this, Kevin, you win a Tootsie Pop.
Oh, really? A grape one?
A grape
not
Tootsie
a root
Pop.
Beer one.
A Tootsie Pop. Well, root beer is fine. The question is, get a close-up again of this beautiful baby. Right here. Get a close-up of that beautiful baby. Who?
Thanks for taking your time.
Who did I impregnate to create this beautiful baby? You want to guess?
Go ahead.
A. Let me think. A, Baby Spice.
Yeah, okay.
B, Vanessa Williams.
Yeah, okay.
C, Meredith Vieira.
All right.
Or D, Lucy Lawless.
Okay, I would say, this is like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Okay.
That's right.
It's not Vanessa Williams because Vanessa Williams, a little too light to be Vanessa Williams.
Okay.
Well. And Lucy Lawless is the other one?
Yes.
Lucy Lawless, it's, I can't tell if that's a gay baby or a straight baby, so it's not Lucy Lawless.
Okay.
Who are the other one? Meredith Vieira. Meredith Vieira, maybe, I don't know, maybe 20 years ago she looked that good, but not anymore. And who's the fourth one?
Baby Spice.
Baby Spice. Well, that's a baby itself. I will say, none of them, I will say, Rosie O'Donnell. No, I will say, Lucy Lawless.
No, you're wrong.
I'm wrong.
Meredith Vieira.
Oh, Meredith Vieira, everybody.
Now, we're going to start off here. Meredith Vieira is not in my top 10. She's not in my top 10, but she wrote me this letter. This is an extra girl. Now, when I put the paper down, then go zoom. Okay, zoom out. You got it. Zoom out. Extra Meredith Vieira. I love you, gorgeous George. I wish so much to give you a baby. Even though I'm not in your top 10, let's try and see if we can create a baby together. Well, my reply to that is, for a middle-aged woman, I found enjoyment in playing with Meredith's organs and produced this lovely creature.
Creature.
Off by the way, got the juice, not milk. Got sperm, right here. Meredith Vieira. Let's get a close-up of her right here.
Yeah, like the money
and
shot.
We all know about
it's
her.
It's like the money shot.
The woman is pushing 50, and she is in The View. She's part of the View girls, and she wanted. And so we got together one steamy August night, and she just gave birth to this lovely baby. We got to put a zoom right back into that baby.
Yeah.
Isn't that a beautiful baby? Isn't that a beautiful baby?
I love it. You said I had a receding hairline. God, the baby. The
Kevin,
baby needs a toupee.
Kevin, maybe it was your sperm.
Mine?
You think it was your sperm? Here.
Move it closer over here.
Take the camera, move it to Kevin.
Wait.
And see, okay.
He wants to see if there's
But don't pull that, Kevin.
He wants to see if it's a...
Now, is there a resemblance or what? Okay. Let's get right into it. Is there a resemblance to that or what?
A little bit of resemblance.
Okay. All right, here we go. Let's get a drum roll, please. Gorgeous George's top 10 women that I want to impregnate. Here we go. Number 10. Get a close-up of this beautiful lady right here. Get a close-up of her.
Yeah.
Lisa Marie Presley. Lisa Marie Presley right here.
You really cut her down the side.
Beautiful woman right here. I'm all shook up. Listen, I'm all shook up about Gorgeous George being the father of my child. Better than Nicolas Cage or that you know what, Michael Jackson. I know my father would give his blessings. George and Lisa would produce a very attractive baby. The baby would become a great singer and gorgeous like Gorgeous George. Obviously, A for, you know, good sperm, A for good intelligence, and a B+ for beauty. There you go. Number 10. Lisa Marie Presley gets a shot.
Okay, now I have to disagree with this now, George. You're not a bad singer, but you're not in Elvis's category. However, I think you are a better singer than Lisa Marie Presley. You're like right in the middle.
Are you horny? Get closer here. Are you horny tonight? Tell me, dear, are you horny tonight? You know, someone said the world's a bit and you had your legs barked. Act one was when we met, when you were my sweetheart. Never seem a change, acted strange. I don't know, but honey, you lied when you said you'll get down with me, and I had no cause to doubt you. I don't want to go hearing more no lies and going on sleeping without you. And you're lying there, and I'm standing there with milk all around. And honey, if you don't go down on me, I got to pull your panties down. Thank you. Thank you very much. Is your heart filled with pain? Is your cut full of blessed sex? Tell me, dear, are you horny tonight? And you know what? Yeah. Lisa Marie Presley, I'm horny for you, baby. Woo! All right.
You thinking of joining the Scientologists? That's a good idea.
You think? Okay.
That's what she sex ever meant.
All right, we got more here.
Yeah.
Number 9.
We have more.
Drum roll.
How many women are you going to impregnate tonight?
Number 9. Lucy Lawless, Princess Warrior Xena. Get a good shot of her right there.
That's not a bad thing.
All right, let me read.
Wait, more of that picture. Don't be so hasty.
Let me read the Dear John letter, one here. Dear Gorgeous, I would give a gorgeous, beautiful baby with an Australian tongue. I know someday he or she would rule the world. What's causing all this? It's Gorgeous George. A plus for juice count. A for the beauty. Lucy Lawless.
Lucy Lawless.
Princess Warrior. An Australian ton.
No? Very nice.
What's your comment about that?
Lucy Lawless, I wouldn't. She could wear that. Those skins anytime.
Did you bring that picture of that beautiful girl earlier? You know the girl I'm talking about?
No. I can get it.
Can you get that for me?
I can get it, sure. While you continue talking, okay. I'll get it.
Now, Vince, do me a favor, if you would. And while Kevin is taking a coffee break, I want you to raise the camera, raise it up, if you would. There you go. Okay, now raise it down. Raise it down. Cleansing. Yeah. Beautiful. Thank you. What's your take upon that, Mr. Vince?
I like Lucy Lawless.
Do you?
I mean, she is very hot.
What do you give her for juice count?
Juice count?
Yes, A or B or C?
A.
Give her A for juice count? What do you give her for beauty or than the body? What do you give for the body?
Oh, A.
Give her A?
Definitely. She's tall, very good-looking woman.
Okay.
I was hoping I'd be able to see her during the Broadway shows of Grease.
What do you give Lisa Marie Presley?
B.
Lisa Marie Presley as far as looks?
Yeah. More like a date.
Okay.
She slept with Michael, so that's...
Well, you can't fault... Look, Vince, we all make mistakes, okay?
That's true.
We all make mistakes. We can't fault her for, you know, feeling that way. You know, that's pretty much what it boils down. We can't fault that. All right, here we go. Now, number 8. Desperate Housewives herself. The Desperate Housewives. Terry... Hatcher.
And it's her at the door, right?
And Avon lady has rang the doorbell, too, by the way. Terry Hatcher. Get a little close about that, if you would, Mr. Vince. Yes. Okay. All right. Terry Hatcher, if I could have the pleasure of carrying your child, Gorgeous George, I can stop doing crappy commercials, Radio Shack commercials, and Superman has nothing on you, Gorgeous. Also, I would have the pleasure of doing a commercial with you for Hanes Our Way. Lots of love, Terry. High juice count, olive skin baby, great thunder in the bedroom. Woo! Who could ask for anything more? Terry Hatcher, number 8.
Terry Hatcher, yeah.
You okay?
She's very desperate as a housewife.
Is she really? Let me read it to you one more time. If I could have
I
the pleasure of carrying your child. Huh?
I've heard it.
You heard it?
Yeah, I heard it.
Okay.
Next,
well,
off to the next one.
Rush, a beautiful thing. Vince, I want some comments now. What do you think about that?
I have not seen her much on TV, so I can't really comment on that.
You can't comment on that?
Yeah, I don't get a chance to watch the show,
yeah.
Nor have I ever seen her in any other TV.
Okay, number 7. Get a load of this girl right here. Baby, do it to me one more time. Britney Spears. Britney Spears right there.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Oops, George, you did it again. But I want to do it with you again and again and again. You know what they say. Practice makes perfect. We would have $1 million baby if I could just have the chance, baby, one more time. Explosion in the bedroom. One child could not be so perfect. But Brittany has slipped in the category for foolish mistakes that she has made. But still hot to trot and a body that will not stop. Woo!
The best body money can buy.
You see that? Okay.
She has a, you're going to have to fight off that cool guy named Kevin. That's her husband, though.
Kevin?
Ooh. Yeah.
Kevin?
Kevin.
Is she married again?
Yeah, she got married twice in 1 year.
Oh,
lovely girl.
What's your comment to that?
I love Britney Spears.
You love Britney Spears?
Yeah. Yeah.
Number 6, Alicia Silverstone. Right here, baby. Alicia Silverstone. She's moved up out of the woodwork. Dear Gorgeous, I play with myself at night just thinking about you being next to your beautiful body. It gets me so hot and excited, I can't hide it. Let's have a baby. Woo! Juice count is off the charts. Real slammer in the hammer, if you know what I mean. Gorgeous and beautiful body. Woo, Alicia. Silverstone.
I'm clueless about that.
You're clueless?
Alicia Silverstone.
You're clueless to that?
Yeah. Hey, Gavalt! Be great.
All right.
We got
more from where that comes.
I'm clueless on
that,
too. Huh? I'm clueless on that, too.
Why are you clueless?
You know, instead of picking 10 women you want to have sex with, why do you keep finding just one nice
These
girl?
These are people...
Why one nice girl
Kevin,
you can marry?
Kevin, let me correct you for a minute. Like I've done before. Let me correct you. These are celebrities.
Oh.
These are celebrities that have emailed me. These are celebrities that have called the house and, you know, talked to Earl, and they, you know, wanted it to say that these things.
Yeah. Wrong number.
Oh. No, they called and they told Earl and said, basically, what is it? Anyway, number five. An oldie but a goodie. Get a close up here. Farrah Fawcett Majors.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's read Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah.
Oh, gorgeous. Can you plant your lips on my grassy knoll? You know we would make a beautiful baby together.
Yeah.
I agree, Farrah. Let's get it on. Let's get it on. And get busy. Kind of old, but still can make some good loving. Farrah Fawcett. Without the major. Without Lee.
Isn't she kind of crazy? You really want a crazy woman?
Can you get a closer on that? A little closer on that. Get a little closer. Okay, that camera's
screwed. She's kind of, I think that's how she really does look now. She makes me dizzy every time I see her.
Children, are we excited here?
Yes.
Are we getting excited? We're getting closer and getting closer and getting closer. Forrest Kelly Ripa, but we don't have a picture of Kelly Ripa. We don't have a picture of Kelly Ripa. Forrest Kelly Ripa. Number three.
You love the housewives, I see.
Number three. Get it closer.
Oh.
Jennifer Aniston.
Yes.
Jennifer Aniston. I'm going to read what Jennifer Aniston
said. I had an Aniston because I had a headache the other day. It was pretty good.
Okay.
It works out.
Hey, gorgeous George. Hey, gorgeous Georgie Porgy. Let's make a baby, Otay. I broke up with that wuss Brad. I know that excites you and excites me. I am all so tingly inside, waiting for your scrub bristles to touch my body. Hey, Georgie, let's make a baby and name it Georgifer. Juices are all flowing for this. Great baby, great combo platter.
Number right four. On. That's
Jennifer Aniston.
Jennifer Anastakis.
There you go. Who loves you, baby?
She kind of has a butter face, though. That's a good picture of her, though. But her face ain't so hot.
Now, number two.
Yeah.
Let me get that beautiful picture there.
All right.
Here's the girl. And of course, I didn't. Here's the girl. Get a close up. Got it.
It's a joke later.
It's a joke later?
No, it's a joke. Don't worry. Okay. It's a joke.
Okay, right here.
Yeah.
Brittany Murphy, Sin City. Brittany Murphy, The Black Book.
King of the Hill,
8 Mile with that scuzzball Eminem. Brittany Murphy. Now, you look closer. Get a little closer to that look here. Looks like my girl Sue a little bit. Right in the eyes.
Yeah.
Looks like my girl Sue right in the eyes.
Yeah.
She and I would make a beautiful baby together.
Yeah.
Make a beautiful baby. And, of course, the number one.
Yeah.
Number one.
Number one.
Is my beautiful girl Sue.
Oh, that's...
Me and Sue, we had a baby. Let me read this to you. Gorgeous George's true love, Sue, had a baby with him and named it Kevin Jane.
All right.
Not knowing if it was a boy or girl. There you go.
Bring it closer.
Get it closer.
All right.
Kevin
this
Jane.
This is very funny. This is very hilarious.
Okay, you blur it. Okay, there you go.
There we go.
Get closer.
There we go.
Kevin Jane.
There, this looks nice.
Kevin is, Kevin, how old were you when we took that picture?
43. Looks good. We make a happy couple here.
Yeah, you know what? I tell you what, you were a hard baby to get out.
I know.
You were a hard baby to get out. And I'm telling you what, you were 40 years old when we took that picture?
Yeah.
Were you?
You know, we, if you haven't already could tell, we're trying to appeal to the women. I don't want to get in your way. We're trying to appeal to the women. So we're reading from this, we take everything from this magazine, Marie Claire, which is for women. And I like to read this all the time. And then I pretend I'm reading it, but I'm actually, reading it, I'm reading this magazine.
Okay.
But then we have those goofballs. The Wednesday night karate explosion. They'd rather, instead of looking at a pretty girl, they'd rather look at the Star Wars punks. So, that's how
anyway,
it goes.
Anyway, is that beautiful baby back there? Check back there for that beautiful baby in the little bag back there. Anyway, and that wraps up Gorgeous George's Top 10 Delights. Gorgeous George's Top 10 Delights. Now, pass that baby over here.
Incoming
baby. Woo. Okay.
Now,
hush, little baby.
Yes.
Now, rumor has it.
Yes.
Do you have that beautiful?
Yes,
beautiful
I do.
Picture?
In fact, I.
Rumor has it.
We've had a little trouble lately. with
perhaps if I got a little closer.
Well, wait, Kevin. Let's this.
Because I got to show the pictures. Okay, it's funny.
We're going to do that.
I mean, it's not funny.
Rumor has it that some imbecile that has a show on this channel is looking for his daddy.
Yes. In fact.
And we said, you know, we know that Luke Skywalker, I'm your father. I'm your father. Yeah. Well, some little idiot here.
Yeah.
Obviously, is looking for his father. Let's show who that idiot is. Well,
here is a picture of him in better days here. And
okay,
there we go.
You got that?
Here we go.
There's that little idiot. There's that idiot.
Okay. So here we go. Is this it? Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, get that idiot in there.
I don't even know what I'm doing.
I'm in there, and I should. Okay. Yeah, let's not. Okay.
There's in better days.
Okay.
When we taught him everything he knew, we blew up the picture. We got it like this, okay. Fine-looking man, if you're Ray Charles or somebody. All right,
and
we actually put his DNA through the FBI channels to see if he could find his father.
And we found his father.
Yeah, we found his father. In fact, he's actually kind of famous.
It's the BTK killer, Dennis Ritter.
And then we got here, and then so. You
be the judge.
Can't do it. Here we go. Yes.
Yes, you be the judge. Kevin, can I see
father
that?
Father and son.
Can I see that beautiful monstrosity?
Together again. All right.
Can I see that beautiful monstrosity? Yes. Bring it over here. Okay. There you go.
Get close.
Get a close up here.
There's no.
Get a close up here.
Gotta get a close.
Now watch. Watch this now. Watch this. Get close up. There you go. Where's my daddy? Son, I'm here. I want daddy. I want to know who my daddy is. Son, I'm right here. I'm sorry that I've neglected you. I'm sorry that I let you out for dry. You're made out of wedlock. We had you out of wedlock, and I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
But daddy, where were you to tuck me in under the covers? Well, I was out there killing women. That's right. Well, daddy, that's a bad example to how to do things. Why did you do that? Why did you kill all these women? Why did you do that? You made me such a dysfunctional person. Well, your mother threw me out, and I needed some protection, and I needed to go out there and start my harem. And I guess with bad sperm and bad parenting, you were created. Oh, daddy. Oh, daddy, get out of here. Leave me alone. Oh, come back, daddy. Leave me alone. Oh, daddy. Where's daddy at? Well, you know what? Hold that.
Oh, okay.
Hold that little thing.
I'm sorry.
I missed you. I missed getting the bird crap on your face last time. Here you go. I missed it last time. Here you go. That's the bird crap.
He has a blank expression.
And that is the abortion.
Yeah.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is the abortion.
You know those nerds.
Of a show.
You know those.
Of a show.
Those nerds. Name their, you know, computer after their penises. Microsoft.
Yeah. All right. Now.
Yes.
We are going to take phone calls, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no.
We are going to take phone calls, and I know you all want to, after everything that's happened, everything has been said, we're going to take some phone calls. Yeah. And Vince, I know that you're happy to know that, and we're going to probably go now.
Vince, why don't you sit down?
Remember, unlike other shows, we are in charge of the Ring Circus. We don't let callers dictate. We don't let callers dictate to what we do. You got something nice to say? By all means, say it. And we'll entertain any thoughts that you have. Tonight was a very entertaining show, probably one of the most entertaining shows that we've done. And now it's time for you callers to throw the roses at me for all that we've done. And we're going to entertain your phone calls right now.
Well, why do I feel like I'm still on Leno?
You're on the air.
Yeah, hello.
How you doing?
Hey, I just wanted to say I loved the show tonight. It was really good.
You liked it?
I'm really glad to see you back on.
Well, thank you, sir. And now, tell us, this is your first show you've seen, or a few other shows you've seen before?
Well, yeah, I saw you guys before, and, you know, like, most nights, because I go to VCU, I like to get...
The VCU. Okay. And of course, you're aware of the other shows that are on this channel, too, right?
Oh, yeah. There's, like, two other shows
hosted
by kids in my building. And I hate those kids.
Yeah.
idiot.
Well, I mean, bad parenting, bad sperm. You got that show, basically, more or less.
Yeah, but I just wanted to say, I think it's really interesting how much Brittany Murphy looks like a girl.
Okay, thank you very much, and I appreciate it. Brittany Murphy looks a lot like her, and I do appreciate that. Line...
Not a good caller.
Line one, you're on the air. Okay, oh. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hi. I just tuned in for the first time.
Okay. And channel surfing.
I found the segment on the Shiloh girl to be rather disrespectful. I think that if that were your daughter who had died, you would not want vegetable jokes made about her.
Let me tell you something. Okay, now, I was not trying to be negative. I wasn't trying to refer to her as a vegetable. I'm trying to talk about the situation and what Congress is trying to do, getting involved. I'm talking about...
I agree with you there, that they should not have gotten involved.
Okay, and I'm also talking about...
The joke got a little carried away.
I'm sorry that you feel that way, but that's not what we were trying to do. Obviously, that's your interpretation, and I will say your interpretation is dead wrong. We were not making fun of the situation. We were referring to her as such. We were saying that she was considered to be that in a state like that because, you know, yes, it's a very controversial issue, but, you know, I'm sorry that you feel that we were offensive to that. We're not trying to be offensive. Line one, you're on the air.
No, that's good.
Hey, what's up, man? I'm your greatest fan.
Well, what's up?
I watch the show all the time.
Well, thank you.
And I hope those geeks are watching. I hate them guys. Yeah. They're out here always talking about how good the show is and how good they are. But you know what? Y'all taught them everything they know. They don't know nothing.
Let me tell you something. I've been doing this...
No, they wouldn't even be on the show now.
That's right. I've been doing this for so long. You know, I love improv. I like to... We love to make people laugh. This man does voice imitations. This man is talented also, too. We do it. We don't have to sit there and walk off the stage and be ticked off about things. We know the callers call in here and start bad-mouthing me. I come right back to them, and I give them a dose of their own medicine. We do it with a little flair, and we've been doing it for the longest time.
Hey, we should call up there and get a lot of people and start making fun of those kids, like joke on them. We should start. That'd be awesome.
Well, you know what? You know, people prank called the show, and people were prank calling him. And he got a little dose of his own medicine. He got off the stage crying in a whimper, you know, and crying and making a big Mr. Do about everything. But you see, you know, being in this for the tenure and the longevity that I've been in this show and this channel, it got to be a degree that, you know, it's like a Porsche and a Pinto. I mean, they're wannabes, and they're where I was about 10 years ago. I have reached that plateau. Thank you very much.
Anyone who told them that those guys, they could just to be themselves, couldn't have given them worse advice.
I'll tell you what. Line two, you're on the air with Gorgeous and Friends.
Hey, I saw you on the internet. I'm from out of town, and I couldn't believe it. I turned on the TV, and here was Gorgeous George.
There you go.
Yes.
While we're here, live in camera, we'll be back on in the summer. We're doing a promo show right now. We did a great show right now. I hope you're enjoying the comedy. Thank you very much. Line one, you're on the air with Gorgeous and Friends. I guess not. Vince, let's talk about your Washington Nationals, how they suck.
They're in first place right now.
They're in first place?
Yeah, they're 2-1. They won this afternoon against the Phillies, 5-4.
You know, they could have been in Las Vegas, that team.
They could have been, but Las Vegas couldn't put up the money for the stadium.
They could have been in Las Vegas, call them the Las Vegas Gamblers. You know, that's what they should have called them.
The Gamblers.
The Gamblers of Las Vegas. Ryan Chu, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Yes, I have a question.
I've got an answer.
You're a fad.
Okay, you know what? I'm a fad. Well, no, I'm a fad in most countries. You know, I'm a fad, but I am what's causing all of this, baby. And whether you like it or don't like it, shut up and eat your banana. Line one, talk to us. You're on the air.
Hey, George. Hey. You're very talented, but you're just too damn fat.
Well, you know what? Your mama wants you to rub dogs with her. Thank you very much. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. See, here's you. Here's me. What'd you say? Click. What did you say? No. Don't think so. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us. Okay, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
I said it.
You know what? I said rub dongs with your granny and your dad and your mommy. Okay, because she's got one too. Okay, obviously. I mean, she's a trisexual. It's obvious.
She'll try anything.
Yes.
She'll try anything.
It's like a triangle, basically. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us. Hello?
You know, calling those callers stupid is an insult to stupid people.
Okay, well, I don't know. You give them an inch, they take a yard. You know, and you try to, you know, give them the opportunity to speak and say whatever they want to say, but they take advantage of it and they abuse their privilege.
You know, this is a very, you know, we don't script. There's no script on this show. We're very good at improvisation. There's no preparation on this show. You know, preparation is for hemorrhoids. We don't do any preparation on this show. And those guys on those other shows, they have no preparation. They have no ad.
We keep it coming.
They cannot ad lib a fart after a bean eating contest.
Oh, I'll tell you what, Kevin. I'll tell you what. We keep it going, and we come back, and we, you know what? We're fast on the trigger. We don't need to let the callers predicate the show, but we give the callers the opportunity to speak their minds. But we don't let the callers predicate or dictate the show. That's all. What it boils down to. And I don't walk off the stage. I don't walk off crying in a whimper. I keep it flowing. Line two, talk to us. Okay, you know what? You know what? Something, you've got to see a doctor. You've got to call 911. Get on your phone and say, Doctor, feel good. I've got the cooties. My bowels are loose. Well, let your doctor take care of that, because I'm sure the people that are listening to this channel don't want to hear that, and neither do we. We don't want to hear that neither.
No.
Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Yes, George.
Yes.
Do you know Jimmy Craig?
Jimmy Craig.
Jimmy Craig.
That's what?
Jimmy Craig. She could probably.
Okay. You know what?
I don't know where it's going.
Yeah. Jimmy Craig.
Jimmy Craig.
We know about Jimmy Craig. I don't know. Do you know about Jimmy Craig? What? What'd you say?
Jenny
Craig. This caller is still on here. Line. Okay. Hello? No, private caller. No, we're not. Okay, that's the deal.
Yeah.
See, I'm not looking at this right. We can't take private calls. We cannot take private calls because it kind of ruins the situation. You know what I'm talking about.
All right.
So.
Yeah.
It's a good show?
Yeah. It's on.
I think it's a good show.
We still got 20 minutes left.
I think it's a great show.
Yes.
Undoubtedly.
No more callers?
Yes.
Well, we'll put them on hold right now. Put them on ice.
Okay.
Vince, now, so, I mean, give us some things that you want to talk about. Talk about the two cases that we were talking about. What's your take? You know, tell the camera. Tell the people on the camera what's your take on what we were talking about.
Oh, the Terry case, you know, the guy was living with somebody. I thought that was wrong. The family tried to keep her alive. Congress did intervene and try to push the bill to try to keep her alive. But, you know, it was a little bit of a waste of money.
Right.
You know, it was a bit of a waste of
money.
But do you
think that it was, I mean, it was long played out? You think they should have taken, I mean, done something a long time ago? Or do you
I
think?
Thought they should have, yes.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I think she should have done something about maybe 5-10 years ago when she was actually in a non-vegetative state. They could have just simply went on ahead and taken some legal action against the husband, went on ahead and just go ahead and say, hey, let me take over because you're not doing a very good job.
My question, Lou, is, do you think, though, by pulling the tube, shouldn't the tube been pulled out longer, or do you think that it should just be kept there? God forbid, I don't want to use that word to because we're not making fun of that. God forbid, I don't want people to think that I'm making fun of a woman that's, you know, in that state.
But in a
state of non-life, state of non-life, do you think that should have been done a long time ago?
No.
To keep her on?
Yeah, it's possible she could have pulled out of it.
Yeah, where there's life, there's hope.
Okay, did we end the calls? I guess.
Well, the Pope never.
I guess
retired.
We have. Okay,
never
there we go.
Retired.
There we go.
Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us. Hello. Guess not.
Who cares?
Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Hello. Hello. Guess not.
Ooh.
Okay, let's see. Wait for the caller ID. We have no cameraman tonight, so that's why it's kind of difficult. We're running off. We have no cameraman, so we're making it a little bit more difficult. Ah, we have that goon himself calling in tonight. Michael Zapperdy is calling tonight.
I heard that he's joining the Marines.
What did you hear?
Heard like Gomer Pyle, you know, Gomer Pyle, USMC.
Right.
He's going to be Michael Rafferty, USMF.
Mr. Rafferty, if you're watching, the BTK killer is your father. Go find him. Reunited. Go find the BTK killer. He is your father. He's the one that left you alone and out of wedlock a long time ago.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what happens when the
Let me clear the phones here. Click. Click.
That's what happens when the this is what happens when the drugstores are closed on April Fool's Day.
Pooshong! Now people are wondering what are you wearing, George?
Yeah.
I am wearing
the Prada
a kung fu outfit.
Versace.
Been taking kung fu for the past 2 months.
Kung fu.
I wanted to do some kung fu moves tonight, and
you can
of course
still do it.
We can still do it. But we're going to go ahead and leave it for another night because we don't have, I mean...
There is no other night.
Well, we're back on in the summer.
Oh, okay.
Well, by the time you get back on, you'll learn more moves.
John Harris, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hello, this is the Pope. Whoever talks about Gorgeous George...
Okay. I'm sorry. Oh, no. Pope, John Harris. I'm sorry. That could have been legit, and I didn't mean to cut you off if it was legit. But anyway, line one.
Did you eat another man?
You've got a gerbil up there, and I can't, so you need to take care of that problem. Line two, talk to us.
Hey, I got a question for you guys.
I've got an answer.
Okay, if Terry Schiavo was a Mexican, do you think anybody would care?
If she was a what?
A Mexican. Meaning if she was a person of color. Yes.
I think so. I think so.
Life is a life.
Indian, African American, Chinese. Yeah, I think so. Mm-hmm. I think so.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know.
We live in a country where everyone has a say.
You don't think so? I mean, you don't think so, or what? Okay, I guess not.
Oh, all right.
Line one, you on the air. Talk to me, Natty.
Hey, George, this is the Pope. Don't hang up. I just have to say something to everybody calling your show, talking garbage to you.
Okay. Hey, Pastor.
Hey, Pastor, do you know what's there? I'm your father. What's going on?
Hey, like the Pope said, you call Gorgeous George talking crap, you must be smoking dope. You can't be smoking dope and talking to the Pope at the same time.
Yes.
So I got to tell all you guys, calling Gorgeous George talking crap to him, don't be mad because you aren't half as good as him, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Guys, and have a good night, okay?
Ciao, Bella.
Ciao, Bella to you, Pope.
Hey.
The Pope is here. Ciao, Bella.
Puta.
That's that right.
Buongiorno, Principe.
Yes.
I'll put it over.
Michael, I'm your father. Why do I want to talk to us?
That Star Wars speak that they know so
talk
well.
To us.
Yeah, I think it's really funny that you say that I look like my dad, because you're a fat.
Okay, you know what? First of all, this is your father, Mr. Michael Rafferty, right here. I'm your father.
All right.
Why do I want to talk to us?
Yo, man, get out the Krispy Kreme diet.
Okay, you know, Krispy Kreme's to you, too. Anyway, we're going down south here.
Down south is a good thing.
Okay, we got a Pennsylvania call. We can't have a Pennsylvania
call. Right.
Now, Pennsylvania call is the wrong number on there, so we're not going to call up any Pennsylvania calls here.
We're big hits on the internet, evidently. Yes. And Pennsylvania has found out about us.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
But you know they ain't watching.
But like I said, you know, there are wannabes and they are the bees. The wannabes and they are the people that, you know, fall a little bit short to what we do. They fall a little bit short from this career. I'm looking at this camera right here.
Yes,
I'm not looking at that
there's
camera.
There's only one camera.
One camera here. I'm looking at the wrong camera.
Yeah.
And that's what it boils down to. There are people that strive to be the best they can, but they can't. Okay? Fall a little bit short. Other shows on here, God bless them. Other shows on here that do a creation and do a show on here, God bless them. But they fall a little bit short from what I do.
Just a little.
I have been in the limelight. I have been the focus in this town. So whether you like it or don't like it, learn, baby, to love it. Because, woo, I am, woo, what's causing all this. One Mona Lisa, one Leaning Tower of Pisa, baby, and only one Gorgeous George. Believe it or not. Hope you all enjoyed the show. We'll be back in June 23rd and July. Gorgeous George Show, 10:15 to 11:30. Be there or be square. God bless. Woo!
To Vince.
And good night.
Vinnie Mac. Gorgeous Woo! George, my name is Kay Lazar. Thanks for watching the return of the Gorgeous George Show.
And we're going to wait.
And all you children out there, eat your vegetables.
Yes.
We've talked enough about them tonight.
That's right.
So... And George, also I'll be in the play Chicago in about a couple of months. I won't play Richard Gere, but I'll play someone in the. I think I'm playing one of the reporters. That should be fun. So come see it in Chester.
It
if you saw the movie, you're gonna love the play.
That's right. Mm-hmm. We're going.
That's it.
We'll see you. God bless.
I want
diamonds forever, baby, and so is Gorgeous George.
Yeah. Okay, we're still on the air.
All right, now,